The pursuit of the Uruk-hai has brought the heir of Elendil to Rohan, just as Saruman declares war on that land. Aragorn and his companions travel to Edoras to aid King Théoden, but their arrival is met with some suspicion. Hello and welcome to the latest episode of The Line Unbroken, my progression-style playthrough series of Lord of the Rings Living Card Game. Here I am continuing my Saga campaign with the second quest from the Treason of Saruman Saga expansion, Helm's Deep. So, all that's on the setup card here is each player may change hero cards without incurring the plus one threat penalty, which I have, and remove certain burdens from the encounter deck, which I also have. Aragorn should be here. And I need to bring in my campaign pool. So, let's see. Right, there we go. Overcome my grief. I like to put my objectives just out of the staging area. Photon Bombadil is in the first player's hand. I took a mulligan with this deck, incidentally, looking for Steward. My original hand already had Shadowfax and some other useful things, but I really wanted the Steward early on. Westeros Traveler, Ride to Ruin, also potentially useful early cards. I likewise took a mulligan with this deck. The first hand I had was fairly tactics heavy, and it also didn't have the main things I'm looking for here, which are Elfstone. Well, I suppose there are a few things. Elfstone is good, Warden of Healing is good, Feint is good, but really probably the biggest two are actually Entdraft and Secret Vigil. Each deck has a plus one to its starting threat. Ill Fate goes into the encounter deck. Beyond All Hope is attached to Gandalf. Leafwrapped Nimbus I'm going to put on Pippin. Three Golden Hairs I'm going to put on Erkenbrand. Valiant Warrior is on Aragorn. And Old Bogey Stories I'm going to put on Merry. So now let's begin this quest. With this setup, set the defense of Helm's Deep and one copy of Deep and Wall aside out of play. Each player sets one copy of Soldier of Isengard aside out of play. Then the players must choose. Either each player shuffles one copy of Poisoned Counsels into his deck, or advance to stage 2A. Bypassing stage 1B. So, Poison Counsels functions like a player card. Forced, after you draw this card, discard all other cards in your hand. Not necessarily an insurmountable problem, but not something you really want to have to do. Especially when the very next quest punishes you for not having... Well, it kind of punishes your... It makes you discard cards, and then the resolution of the end causes you problems based on how many cards you have left. Also, if you ever run out of cards in hand, you lose the game. At least, by the end. So, yeah, that's not so pleasant. Of course, having Gandalf, Wizard Pipe, I could potentially deal with it, but I would rather not, and of course, it's a global thing. I can't take it with one deck and not with the other. So, I'm just going to stick those in the victory display so they're out of the way, because I am choosing to advance to stage 2A, bypassing 1B. I need two Soldiers of Isengard. So, this is the quest stage to which I am not going. which gets each player a free ally, which admittedly would be nice, and skip the quest phase and the combat phase, so essentially a free round and a free ally. It's a big boost if you can, if you feel that you're okay with poisoned councils, but I don't want to take poisoned councils. So instead I go to stage 2A. At the behest of Gandalf, Aragorn and his companions ride to Helm's Deep with the men of Rohan and their king. As the sun goes down, the valley below the Deeping Wall fills with the approaching army of Isengard. When revealed, add the defense of Helm's Deep and each set-aside copy of Soldier of Isengard to the staging area. Make Deeping Wall the active location. Shuffle the encounter deck, then each player reveals one encounter card. So, the defense of Helm's Deep. Add one to the total threat in the staging area for each resource token here. That's why I'm actually putting it in the staging area, where usually I tend to put objectives off to the side, because it's in the staging area. I will hopefully remember that it contributes threat, something I have been known to forget in the past. Forced, at the end of the quest phase, place one resource token here. If there are 8 resource tokens here, add the defense of Helm's Deep to the victory display and advance to stage 5A. Deeping Wall is the active location. 4 threat, 4 quest points. While Deeping Wall is the active location, each hero gets plus 1 defense. Forced, when Deeping Wall is explored, raise each player's threat by 4. And Soldiers of Isengard. 39 engagement cost. 4-4-1-4. Toughness 1, archery 1. Forced, after Soldier of Isengard attacks and destroys a character, place 1 progress on the current quest. And now each deck reveals an encounter card. So let's just shuffle the deck again and reveal Reckless Hate. Well, that's annoying. Peril, the enemy in the staging area with the highest attack makes an immediate attack against you. If no attack is made this way, Reckless Hate gains Surge. An attack is made this way, so Erkenbrand will defend it. Return attacking enemy to the staging area after this attack. It's already in the staging area, and at least I'm not revealing that copy of Knight Without End as a treachery, because I really don't like that card, especially right at the start of the game. Erkenbrand takes no damage because he is 4 defense with the boost from the Deeping Wall. And the card revealed for second deck here, an Isengard Uruk. So, when revealed, either assign 3 damage among characters you control, or reveal an additional encounter card. I will deal the damage. Right. It's flipped over. 8 quest points. Defense. Forced, at the end of the combat phase, if the number of enemies in the staging area is less than the number of players in the game, the first player reveals an encounter card. And forced, at the end of the round, place 1 progress here for each enemy in the staging area, bypassing any active location. So, the defense keyword, for those who do not know, is unique to this quest. It appears on stages 2, 3, and 4, and what it means is the questing is reversed. The encounter deck is attempting to make progress, and we are trying to stop it. So, we quest as normal, but then when it comes to resolution, we compare our willpower to the threat in the staging area. If our willpower is greater, then nothing happens. If our willpower is less, then instead of raising our threat, as we usually would for questing unsuccessfully, the encounter deck makes progress on the quest, as we usually would. And so it's a bad thing for progress to go on the quest in Helm's Deep. So, those explanations aside, let's control M and start the game. Okay. Let's see. Shadowfax would be a great thing to start with. Steward of Gondor, obviously, it would be nice to save up for that. Or Galadriel. I could play Harmer from the top of my deck. Yeah, actually, Harmer can serve a similar purpose to Shadowfax. Because Shadowfax obviously gets me the extra action out of Gandalf, who has great stats. Harmer can provide me with some combat power, which is what I would get out of that extra action from Gandalf. So, factoring in the cost reduction from Theoden, I will play Harmer, and of course I'm playing him from the top of my deck with Gandalf's ability. So, that I guess is all for this deck. Over here, well, let's play this Daron's Runes. Elfstone and Henemar. Yeah, I think I will play both of those. Elfstone and Henemar. Exhaust Henemar to look at the top card of the encounter deck, which is a Deeping Culvert. So, since this deck controls one ally, that Deeping Culvert will be 2 threat, meaning the threat in the staging area will be 4, 8, 10, 12. Plus one more card revealed. So, now, of course, the Elfstone still functions normally if it gives plus one quest point to this location, which I kind of don't want to be explored, so that's useful. But then, when the location is explored, I will still get to bring in an ally. And so that will be handy, especially because I would quite like to avoid the threat raising 4. But if it does happen, and I thus have to immediately engage these soldiers of Isengard, it will certainly be useful to have an extra body for combat that I would not have otherwise had. However, I would prefer, if possible, to trigger the Elfstone next round and bring in Legolas instead. And yes, I am saving my tactics resource for a feint. Arod is actually potentially useful in this quest, but it's not going to be as useful as a feint, especially not early on. So, 12 threat in the staging area, plus one more card. I definitely want to quest with Gandalf. So it's 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Questing with Treebeard can be very significant early on, since his ability will allow me to correct my questing by dealing damage to him. I will obviously then have to heal him. Fortunately, I do have a Warden of Healing already in my hand, so that will help. Anyway, questing for 12. I reveal the Deepened Culvert, and Devilry of Saruman. Well, I don't have a means of cancelling this, but I'm actually okay with that right now. Obviously, I'm breaking even, so I don't need to damage Treebeard. And I don't need anyone else's text boxes for the rest of this round. Technically, the blank text boxes means I should stop this being visible, but it's not that important because Gandalf's text box will be back by the time I actually do anything with this. So, I didn't actually read the card. Place 3 progress on the current quest, bypassing any active location. Until the end of the round, treat each character's text box as if it was blank, except for traits. So, there we go. That's my staging. There is 12 threat in the staging area against my 12 willpower. No progress is made. That was actually potentially one of the best possible times that I could have revealed Devilry of Saruman. Now, of course, here, if the number of, at the end of the combat phase, the number of enemies in the staging area is less than the number of players in the game, the first player reveals an encounter card. I would rather not do that. Honestly, obviously, leaving enemies in the staging area will then cause the second forced effect to go off, and place one progress here for each enemy in the staging area. But honestly, stage 2, with these two forced effects that kind of feed off each other, well, counteract each other, make it so that there is no good option. They kind of mean that stage 2 can be the worst of the stages to actually deal with. So I don't mind getting pushed through this one onto stage 3. So, I do not have to engage the Soldiers of Isengard. I do have to engage this Isengard Uruk. But also I will be able to kill it. So, shadow card, archery 4, 1 from each of the soldiers and 2 from the Uruk. I will deal that archery 3 points to Théoden and 1 to Aragorn. And then I will play this feint. So the Isengard Uruk does not attack. Aragorn attacks for 4, Harmer attacks for 2. The Uruk is dead. Oh, sorry, at the end of the quest phase, I place a resource on the defense of Helm's Deep. This is a good start. It's possible to have some very bad starts in this quest, but thankfully I have not on this occasion. Things could still go horribly wrong, though. Draw the card over here. Right. So now might be the time for Arod. Although I could hold off on Arod. In fact, yeah, I have no particular burning desire to explore the Deepen Culvert. So I can potentially wait and put Arod on Legolas, assuming I let the Deepen Wall go and Elfstone Legolas into play. Let's use Henemark. The Hornburg. That's reasonable. I might be able to hold on to this for a bit longer. But it can be risky to keep committing a lot to quest. Oh, at the end of the round, place one progress here for each enemy in the staging area. Just two. It can be risky to try too hard to hold on to a quest station in an active location. Partly because, of course, if the... Well, it's like location lock. If you do not let the active location get explored, then you'll keep mounting up threat in the staging area in the form of locations which you can't travel to. So letting them go periodically can be useful so you can travel to new ones and don't have as much threat mounting up in the long run. And also because if you're committing a lot of characters to the quest to ensure that the encounter deck doesn't make too much progress, then you don't have so many actions for combat when you could really use them to actually kill some of these enemies so that you won't have to keep dealing with them. So it definitely, there's definitely a big consideration on deliberately losing the quest, sometimes even to the point of not questing at all, just so you can hold bodies back for combat and kill the enemies, get the board state under control. So, at this point, yeah, I think I'm going to hold on to the tactics resource. Now, the Warden of Healing would be great to obviously keep this damage under control. I'm going to have Archery 2 still. And then there's the possibility of... there's the possibility of more archery. There's the possibility I might want to damage Treebeard, either to quest harder or to kill something. On the other hand, Quickbeam is another body on the table. More useful stats. I suppose that would mostly be relevant for his attack power, because if I play him, that wouldn't... If I were to quest with him, well, that would increase the threat in the staging area by me playing him. So it would just even out as one more willpower, and I can get one more willpower by... I suppose playing the Warden would also increase the threat in the staging area. So it is still a difference. I would get one more willpower out of Quick Beam than I would out of playing the Warden and healing Treebeard, so that he could deal the damage to himself to make me more progress, but still, I suppose it's a matter of how in control I expect it to be. Let's see, 1, 5, 9, currently 11, and then we're revealing the Hornburg, which is 3 threat, so 14 threat in the staging area. Now, of course, I don't mind some progress going in Leaping Wall. Indeed, as I said, I might be okay with the Deeping Wall just getting explored. The problem would be the threat raise of 4, which would mean that I would have to engage these soldiers of Isengard. Of course, having Legolas in play would make them easier to deal with. So, I might want to see if I can figure out a way to quest carefully so the Deeping Wall is explored but the quest stage is not, if I can manage that. Which I might be able to. So, but then if the Deeping Wall is explored, then I have to deal with 2 or possibly 3 enemies. Erkenbrand is ready now. I've got Hammer, so I guess that would be defenses pretty well solidified. Theoden and Legolas could kill something. And Aragorn and Merry, if I wanted to really focus on that. And the killing. I don't have to kill everything instantly, either. Let me count on my willpower. 2, 4, 8. I think I'm going to play this Westward Traveler. So 10. Potential to damage Treebeard. This is pretty okay, and doesn't seem like I need Quick Beam. So, play the Warden of Healing. Okay, so technically we aren't exhausted yet. Now I play the Westward Traveler for 1 with Fairdings discount. And I pay 2 for Steward of Gondor on Aragorn, which is another point of course. Aragorn has the ability to ready heroes by spending resources. So since he has 4 resources, I can potentially ready 2 heroes in an emergency. But let's see, questing 2, 4, 8, 10 against, it's going to be 14 plus 1 more card. If I want the Deeping Wall to be explored, it currently has 5 quest points. So I may well just go for this. And I have other options as well. So yeah, alright. Reveal the Hornburg. Sorry, it'll be 15 threat. I didn't factor in my playing an additional ally into the threat of the Deacon Colbert. 1, 5, 9, 12, 15, and now 19. Okay. So as it stands, 9 progress. I do not want it to be 9 progress. So I'm going to heal Treebeard and Aragorn for starters, and then deal damage to Treebeard. I'm going to go for 4 damage, which is as much as I can do without killing him, so the encounter deck only makes 5 progress. Thus exploring the Deeping Wall, but putting nothing on the quest. Since the Deeping Wall is explored, and the Elfstone along goes with it, I put Legolas into play, and also both decks raise their threat by 4 for the Deeping Wall. So, as I said, I will now have to engage the Soldier of Isengard. Another resource goes onto the defense of Helm's Deep. Now, I might just travel to another Deeping Wall. It'd get me that extra point of defense on Erkenbrand. On the other hand, going to the Hornburg would mean no archery damage. I'm going to the Deeping Wall. And so I'll optionally engage a soldier here. Its engagement cost is higher than my threat, so I draw a card for Pippin. Do Entmoot. I'll just play that now. Search the top 5 cards of my deck for more Ents. 2 more Entmoots. I'll take them. And then play them. See, I'm wanting to thin down the deck in hopes of finding another Warden of Healing would be nice. Secret Vigils, kind of the big thing. Obviously, Ent Loot will be better when I have more Ent cards available to me in an expanded card pool, but still decent. Okay, Ent Draft, that is the one Ent card that I was really looking for as well. Since I already have Quick Beam in hand. So, not the best result for using 3 Entmoots, But I'll take it. It's thinned my deck a little bit, and the end draft is the thing that I really wanted. And so now I'm engaged the other Soldier Rises and Guard here. Deal out Shadow cards. Archery 2 goes here. Erkenbrand will defend here. Attacking enemy makes an additional attack against you after this one. I will deal the damage to Erkenbrand to cancel that shadow effect. And now, Armor will defend here. Attacking enemy gets plus 2 attack and gains toughness 2 until the end of the round, so it's attacking for 6. I trigger Armor's combat action to ready him and give him plus 3 defense until the end of the phase. He still takes 1 damage, 6 attack against 5 defense, but that's fine. Now, Aragorn and Merry attack for a total of 6. Merry is 2 because I have 2 Hobbit heroes, and Aragorn is 4 because of Valiant Warrior. 1 defense, 1 toughness, and 4 hit points. This Soldier of Isengard is dead. Now, over here, Théoden is 3, Hammer is 2, and Legolas at ranged is another 3, for a total of 8 attack. It would be 6 normally. This has an extra toughness 2 from its shadow effect, but that is still fine to kill it with 8 attack. So it is dead. Trigger Legolas to draw a card. Okay, and now, of course, since I triggered Helmer's combat action, he is going to be discarded at the end of the phase. I'm going to preempt that by using Gandalf to play Ride to Ruin from the top of my deck. Discard a Rohan ally to choose a location, place 3 progress tokens on that location. I will choose to discard Helmer, obviously, and place 3 progress on the Hornburg. Because I never read it. But while it's the active location, reduce the archery total by 1 for each player in the game. Enforced when it's explored, assign X damage among characters in play. X is the number of enemies in play. There are currently no enemies in play, so this is a great time to do this. And especially because Hammer was going to be discarded anyway. Incidentally, the Deacon Culvert, which I also didn't read, has X threat, where X is 1 more than the number of allies controlled by the first player, and when it's explored, each player searches the encounter deck and discard part of an enemy, reveals it, and adds it to the staging area. This one I am less keen on exploring ever, because extra enemies... I mean, I can get to a position where I can deal with the enemies, but they're still kind of a problem. So, I'm doing pretty well here. Need to get some healing done, but I'm doing pretty well. Now, at the end of the combat phase, if the number of enemies in the staging area is less than the number of players in the game, the first player reveals an encounter card, so I will do that. Scaling ladders. Surge, and reveal attached to the active location. Answer the siege attachment with the text, each enemy gets +1 threat. That's annoying. Do not like scaling ladders. So at the moment, of course, there are no enemies in play, so right now it's not doing anything, but it surges into another deeping wall. But the second forced effect, of course, will place no progress on the quest. So, we are doing pretty well here. Control N. And dear Aragorn has a massive stack of resources ready to do some readying if I need more actions. Now, okay, so now may be a good time for Shadowfax. Yeah, I think I want to save. Oh, actually, playing Arwen from the top of my deck could be a good idea. I would like to save for this greeting, but Arwen is really good. I'm going to play Shadowfax with Aragorn's resources. So, on the off chance of Devilry of Saruman, Viking text boxes, I'm going to heal now. Tribute of Erkenbrand. And yeah, let's play Arwen from the top of my deck. Bring a Barra here, okay. Henema. Helm's Gate, okay. So, over here, I definitely want this Ent Draft right away. I'm going to put Arod onto Legolas. Did I forget to discard these Daron's runes? Well, clearly I did because it's the bottom card of my discard pile, but I distinctly remember intending to discard my second copy of Arald because I had to. Right, I have one law resource left, so I guess I will play the Fast Hitch onto Merry. Now, for the moment, unless I specify otherwise, Arwen will simply target Erkenbrand. Because while he's already a sentinel, he could do with a little more defense. So, threat in the staging area is 2, 5, 9, and I'm about to reveal a 5 threat location. So, 14. As a side note, I've forgotten what that side note was about to be. Oh, yes, the Deeping Culvert. The other aspect is, one might think, or, well, yeah, sometimes at least, one might think of using location control, like Ride to Ruin, to deliberately explore a location and get the threat out of the staging area. The thing with the Deeping Culvert is, of course, it would get me two enemies, which would even though the Deeping Culvert can end up as a lot of threat, if I get a lot of allies into play, it would end up with me getting two more enemies, which would also be a decent amount of threat. Of course, I get to search the encounter deck and discard pile for an enemy and choose which one I want, so I can choose the lowest threat enemies in the quest, though they do have an annoying when revealed. But, you know, it's still, assuming no scaling ladders in play, that's still 4 threat with 2 players. So there's some scope for the Deepened Culvert to really not be that bad. Okay, so I'm obviously questing with Arwen. 2, 4, 6, 8. Yeah, I really need to do some threat reduction, so I definitely want to save for this greeting. Because, you know, if this Deeping Wall gets explored, then this deck will go up to 47 threat. And it'll be getting pretty dicey. So, okay, so what was I up to? I think I was up to 14, wasn't I? 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Yeah, okay. I reveal Helm's Gate and a Soldier of Isengard. Not bad, man. Nope, still no, yeah, no sign of a secret vigil, which obviously would be great on this guy. But okay. So that brings me up to 18 threat in the saving area. So I'm losing by 4, which would explore the Deepening Wall. There's potential for me to get screwed over if I accept that threat raise. Right, I've seen one copy of Knight Without Aid. I don't off the top of my head know how many there are. This is the only doomed card in the deck. Hang on, I'm going to check how many there are, because this is rare. Alright. There are 2 copies of Knight Without End. So there is 1 left. Scaling Ladders, this is 5 threat, not 4. So with 24 cards left in the encounter deck, chances of me revealing it are not great. I might still want to not take that chance. Potentially I really shouldn't have played Arwen. I should have just immediately been saving for the greeting. I think it's too risky, so I'm just going to deal 2 damage. So the encounter deck places 3 progress. And now, okay. I will have to engage this Sword of Isengard here. Another resource goes here. I would like to engage it here and draw a card for Pippin, but if I want to have the attack power to kill it, it needs to be here. So, Earthenbrand defends, takes no damage, and I have easily enough attack power to kill it, including Legolas, who will draw a card for this deck, which is another copy of Legolas, and Exhaust Arod to place a progress on Helm's Gate, because Helm's Gate, 5 threat, 3 quest points. While it's the active location, if any player is not engaged with an enemy, the first player reveals an encounter card at the end of each staging step, so you don't really want to travel there. And then forced, when Helm's Gate is explored, each enemy gets minus 20 engagement cost and plus 2 attack until the end of the round. Of course, if I can manage to explore it with Arod, which only triggers when Legolas attacks and destroys an enemy, at that point all attacks for the round are done, so I don't care if they get their engagement cost reduced and their attack increased, because they can no longer do anything with their engagement costs and attacks. So, at the end of the combat phase, there is less than 2 enemies in the staging area, so I have to reveal a card, which turns out to be another copy of Scaling Ladders. Well, I mean, in some ways, like, realistically, I'm going to lose this Deepening Wall at some point. Having 2 copies of Scaling Ladders go with it instead of just 1 is actually potentially a win, and there is Night Without End, which is a bit of a problem. I have to really hope that I can find some threat reduction. So, damage 2. And either remove one resource token from the defensive helm's deep or reveal two additional encounter cards. I will remove the resource. Control N. I mean, I feel like I've pretty much got this under control, except for my threat. My threat is the problem. Well, the first deck's threat is the problem. Deck 2 is alright. 35 is not a problematic threat value. Okay, so I want to save Tactics Resource for Feint. Go for quick beam, but I think alright, just go for the wandering int. And then let's heal Treebeard and Théoden. Okay. Théoden's discount. I will play Horse Breeder from the top of my deck for 0, and then search the top 10 cards of my deck. There are no horses in there. Shuffle it up. Okay, Cram is probably irrelevant at this point. And of course I already played from the top of my deck this phase, so I can't bring it in immediately. Okay. How many allies? 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is 5 threats. So 2, 7, 11, 16. And what does Henemoth say? A high fighter with two scaling ladders. So that would be 21 threat. So I need to quest pretty hard. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11, 13. 13, 15. 19. That's worrying. Yeah, that's very worrying. Okay, so I'm gonna say quick beam instead of wandering in, so I can have an extra 2. Bringing me to the point of breaking even. I'm gonna send Earthenbrand. Sending everything I've got. Yeah, okay. So what do I do? So we reveal the Kai Fighter and Warrior of Dunland. Harrow Archery 1, when revealed, makes an immediate attack against you. So let's defend with Gandalf. Okay. Well, that is another 6 threat. 27. Okay. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to deal 1 damage to Treebeard to increase my willpower to 23. And then I'm going to pay 1 for Ride to Ruin, discarding a Westfold Horsebreeder, to place 3 progress on Helm's Gate, which explores it and thus removes 5 threat from the staging area. I have just lost 1 willpower that I was questing with, of course, but now I'm breaking even. Now these 2 enemies have minus 20 engagement cost and plus 2 attack until the end of the round, but on the plus side, I don't have to raise my threat by 4 and instantly lose when the Dipping Wall gets explored, which it otherwise would have been. So, I put another resource on here. And now, let's see. Which way round do I want these? I have a feint, don't I? Yes. Excellent. I suppose it doesn't matter that much. Well, actually maybe it does. It takes 7 to kill a fighter. And only 6 to kill a warrior of diamond. I'm going to faint the Warrior of Dunland. Erkenbrand will defend the fighter. And then I need to kill things. So, yes, okay. So, engage like this. Shadow, shadow. Archery 1 from the Warrior of Dunland. Put it on Arwen. And then, yes, I pay 1 to feint the 7 attack Warrior of Dunland. I will then pay 2 resources from Paragon to ready Erkenbrand and have him defend the Urukai fighter. He takes no damage because, thanks to Arwen and the Deepened Wall, he is currently 5 defense. Then let's ready up Aragorn himself. Attack for 4, 6, 9. Kill the Urukai fighter. Draw a card for Legolas, which is a secret vigil, therefore I will not bother killing the Warrior of Dunland. However, I will ready Legolas and deal a couple of damage to him to make it easier. Oh, I could have triggered Arod when I killed the fighter. If I wanted to put a progress, I guess I'll put a progress on the culvert, just on the off chance that I ever do want to get rid of it. Discard that shadow card, control N, Aragorn moves back over here, steward, put a card here. Okay, so this cram. Tree bearing? Although, actually, I'm pretty heavy on attack here. Well, okay, so one thing I'm definitely doing is playing Sword That Was Broken onto Aragorn, because I really need willpower to make sure that I don't. Oh, end of the combat phase, I have to reveal a card. Which, okay, until the end of the round, each enemy engaged with you adds its threat to the total threat in the staging area. but that's fine because it was already after the quest phase. But I do have to find an Uruk-hai enemy, reveal it, and put it into play engaged with me, so let's just take the one that does not have a when revealed effect, and here it is. Actually, unless I want to go grab a Soldier of Isengard out of the discard pile, and then I could draw a card, or another card rather. There'll be more archery damage, of course. Wouldn't be a problem for me to kill it. Yeah, let's stick with the fighter. Oh, and shuffle the encounter deck. And then, now back in the present, trigger Henema, Postum Door, that's not an enemy, which is good. So, yes, I played the sword that was broken. I will also play 3 for Galadriel. Top 5 cards. Yeah, let's take an unexpected courage. And then put everything like this. So, where do I want that unexpected courage? Realistically, my courages are likely to go on Erkenbrand and Aragorn, maybe? So, yeah, let's just go for Aragorn first. Actually, no, I might... Yeah, more defenses could be useful. Let's go for Erkenbrand first. I have another one coming up, of course. Then I will play the River Barrier here from the top of my deck with Gandalf. So I now have a Test of Will on top of my deck, ready to go. And I should play this Cram. Treebeard would be a possibility, Theoden would be a possibility, Aragorn would be a possibility. Aragorn is going to get the next unexpected courage, so Treebeard or Theoden, really. Or Gandalf, actually. Let's go for Treebeard. Okay. And passing Clever over to here, I will of course play this Secret Vigil onto the Warrior of Dunland, since that's the reason I left him alive. And now, I guess I'll play the Wandering Ent as well. Now let's do some healing. Treebeard and Theoden. Actually, no. Treebeard and Pippin. And now questing. There is 3, 2, 3, 7, 11 threat. And I'm about to reveal a prison door, which is another 3. So there will be 14 threat plus one more card. So let's quest with the boost from the sword that was broken. 3, 7, 10, 12, 14, 16. Don't think I can get more than 7 threat out of one card revealed. So, questing for 21. Reveal the Postum Door and an Isengard Uruk. Which is 4 threat, but not 7. So, we'll be a total of 18 threat. I have to when revealed, assign 3 damage among characters you control. 1, 2, 3. So I have quested successfully. I add another resource here. I will have to engage this Uruk. See, where will be easier to kill it? I don't know. Actually, yeah, I need very little attack to kill this warrior of Dunland, valued 4. So I'll have attack power to spare on this side. So I'm going to engage here or up here. Shadow cards. Archery 3. Let's not trigger Overcome by Grief, so I'll only put 2 onto Galadriel. And the third can go on there. So now, Erkenbrand. Defend against the Warrior of Dunland. Scout a non-objective attachment you control. I suppose I do have a spare copy of the Ring of Barra here. But I also want to be saving my spirit resources. You know what? I have access to healing. I will just cancel that shadow effect with Erkenbrand. And yeah, let's just go Erkenbrand on the cross. Ready him with Aragorn's resources and defend this one as well. Place 1 progress on the active location. No. Cancel that as well. Okay, so attack for 4 and kill this Warrior of Dunland. And each deck lowers its threat by 4, giving me a little bit more breathing room. And then attack for 7, kill this Isengard Uruk. And then attack for 2, 5, 8. Kill this Uruk High Fighter. Now, actually, I could do Deepen Culvert now, pull out 2 new enemies, and then I wouldn't have to reveal an extra card for this forced effect. On the other hand, I could go for Posting Door. At the end of the combat phase, I have to reveal a card, which turns out to be the Isengard Uruk. So, sorry, 3 damage. I will assign it to Aragorn. And then at the end of the round, there is an enemy in the staging area, so I have to put another progress on there. I think I want to move to the right a little bit, so Aragorn has a little bit more space. Galadriel will be discarded at the end of the round. And control them. Of course, having taken a few rounds to sort out that secret vigil, this deck is still high on threat, but I do have that greeting ready to go. And, okay, I just drew another secret vigil. I don't have another... Oh, hang on, yeah. I should have drawn that with Legolas. Legolas got the last kill, so it wouldn't have helped. Because I don't have a high threat enemy in play, so I probably want to wait for one. So yeah, let's just play this beaming ant. And over here. Play this unexpected courage off the top of my deck onto Aragorn. So, okay. Now, yeah, I can leave my hearing for later. So, first in the stage here is. Oh, yeah, Hanemoth. Hillman. That'll be another 5 threat. 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 allies. Actually, I'm going to not play that booming ant just because it adds more threat to the staging area. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 10, 14, 17, 21, 26. I'm bringing both scaling ladders. So, okay, left over 4, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 17, 19, 23, 25, 28. I've seen both copies of Night Without End, so I don't have to be too worried, actually. So, yeah, okay, 28. Reveal Hillman, and the third copy of Scaling Ladders. I could cancel it, but I'm not going to. It surges into another postern door. So, so that's another 3 threat from the postern door, and another 2 from the third copy of Scaling Ladders. So 31. So that would be 3 progress, which would of course clear the Deeping Wall. It would also advance the quest. I'm not so sure about advancing the quest, though. It might be okay. Yeah, you know what? I will just let this go. Each deck grows if it's threat by 4. It 37, and we advance the quest. Against the deeping wall, the hosts of Isengard roared like a sea. Orcs and hillmen swarmed about its feet from end to end. When revealed, search the encounter deck, discard pile, and victory display for Helm's Gate, and add it to the staging area. Shuffle the encounter deck, make Helm's Gate the active location, returning any previous active location to the staging area. So let's quickly take a look at what's left in the encounter deck. Okay. That's interesting. But of course not Helm's Gate. Let's get Helm's Gate out of the discard pile. There we go. Here comes the active location. Hundreds of long ladders were lifted up. Many were cast down in ruin, but many more replaced them. Defense. Forced, after resolving the quest, if the encounter deck did not place at least one progress on this stage as the result of questing, the first player reveals one encounter card. Worth noting, though it's not explicit on the card, a rules question was submitted to Caleb and he confirmed that this is not intended to immediately trigger. Because technically you could definitely read it that way. You've just resolved the quest and it's caused you to advance. But the encounter deck did not place progress on this stage, it placed progress on the last stage. But no, you're not supposed to immediately reveal an extra card. At least advanced. So, end quest phase. And the resource goes here. Now, Hillman, this is the guy that I want to secret vigil. So I can't kill him. The Isengard Uruk is totally fair game for being killed. I'm going to have archery too. That's fine. Let's have them this way round. Shadow. Erkenbrand will defend against Hillman. He takes no damage. Archery 2. Gandalf. And Erkenbrand will defend against the Isengard Uruk. He again takes no damage. So I'm not going to kill the Hillman. Gandalf and Legolas will kill Uruk. Trigger Legolas to draw a card. Trigger Arad to place one progress on this posted door, which is explored, and until the end of the round, players cannot declare attacks. It's fine, because I've already declared all the attacks that I wanted to. Now, I should do some healing. So, let's heal up Treebeard and Erkenbrand, and then of course I can pay lore resources to ready the Warden. So, let's pay a couple of lore resources and ready the Warden. And then heal again Treebeard and Erkenbrand. I'm going to leave it at that for now. Actually, no, I'm going to pay two of Aragorn's resources since he has a lore icon from the Barra here. Ready the Warden again and heal Treebeard and Aragorn. Discard that shadow card. Up the Wild Hillman, put progress on Helm's Gate. The three cards left in the hand deck. I should know what they are at this point. But I can't remember. Oh, actually, hang on. Let's heal Gandalf and the Aragorn. So, yes, disadvantage of having killed that Isengard Uruk is I will have to reveal an extra card for Helm's Gate. because a player is not engaged with an enemy, and so the first player will reveal any counter card at the end of the staging step. So I will be revealing all three of the remaining cards in the encounter deck. Never mind. Drop in. Okay. Yes, there we go. Aragorn moves over here. I found Gandalf's stuff. That's very nice to see. I also have three spirit resources with which to play Gladwin's Greeting. So let's do that. So that I'm not completely dependent. There shouldn't be a way that I could get my threat raised before I kill this Hillman, but just to be sure. Yes, this deck draws a card. Talus Hunters, okay. And now, I do not have Calabrian Stone on Aragorn, so he does not have a spirit icon. Alright, let's go to the Gandalf Staff. Okay. And then exhaust the staff to put a resource onto Theoden so that I can afford a test of will. And then could just play Gimli. Yeah, let's play Gimli. Two of those resources can come from Edmund Land. And over here, I can almost afford Barney, so I'll continue saving my tactics resources. But I think I'll play Glaewyn. I'm exhausting to have this deck draw a card. Galadriel, okay. Nice card to draw. So, not that much. 1, 2, 3. So this is 4 threat. So, 9. 13, 16. I do remember that one of the cards I'm about to reveal is Devilry of Saruman. I'm not entirely sure that that will be a problem. Because I should be able to quest pretty hard. Although, yeah, I suppose I potentially want to. I looked at the encounter deck earlier when I went looking for Helm's Gate, so I should know what these cards are. I could have made a note of it, but I was really bothered. Deepen Culvert and Wild Hellman. Okay. So the Wild Hellman is 3 threat. The Deepen Culvert will be 4, so I'm going to add 7 threat. So there's going to be 20, 23, not 32, 23 threat in the staging area, and I will, yes, I will have to reveal all 3 of those cards because of Helm's Gate. However, if I want to avoid revealing the extra card from the forced effect on this quest card, then I need the encounter deck to make 3 progress. So if I quest for 20, then I'll be fine. So 3, 6, 9. Eleven. 13. 15, 20. Oh yeah, I was going to play on Secret Vigil. Yeah, I will play the Secret Vigil. So, yeah, I don't think I'm going to need my text boxes, so I don't need to cancel Devil Rear of Saruman. So we reveal Deacon Culvert, Devil Rear of Saruman, which places free progress on the quest, and blanks text boxes. And a Wild Hillman, which raises Gimli. So, like I said, 3, 7, 10, 14, 18, 23 versus my 20. 1, 2, 3 progress. Helm's Gate is explored, so these Hillmen have an engagement cost of 4 and 5 attack right now. Not a problem. I will travel to the Deepening Wall. And engage here. I'm going to use Henemoth to see what the first shadow card is. Oh no, I'm not because his text box is blank. So just forget. I was going to defend both of them with Erkenbrand anyway, so there should be a resource here. Erkenbrand defends. Erkenbrand defends again. Attacking me makes an additional attack after this one. Gandalf defends. Turn attacking into the staging area after this attack. Okay. Gandalf is still a sentinel from Shadowfax. So Aragorn, Theoden, Gimli, and Legolas can all attack for a lot and kill a Hillman. Trigger Legolas to draw a card. Trigger Arod to place one progress on the postern door. Use the Warden of Healing to heal Treebeard and Aragorn. Discard this shadow card. Aragorn moves over. Then control N. I just want to mention, this may look like it's not that difficult, and right now it's not, but that's because I got a good start. If I'd gotten a bad start, like say early scaling ladders can make it have a massive impact. Just early Helm's Gate, just because it's 5 threat. Early Devilry of Saruman is sometimes bad, sometimes good, depending on your text boxes. There are various things which can cause this quest to just go wrong early on. And it's just that I managed to avoid those pitfalls. Okay, it's a gross grey line. Have this deck draw a card. And Andrew draws Henemoth to look at the top card of the encounter deck, fighting Uruk-hai. It's peril, so I can't cancel it. But I get to choose what enemy I find, of course. So, let's see. Right, yes. I exhaust Gandalf's staff to give another resource to Merry so that I can afford to play Boromir. I'm running out of space for my allies, that's just a guy I'll have to die a bit. And have another. I could play Elrond as well. Since Aragorn does have a lore icon. Just to speed up the healing process, I think. Elrond, and he'll fully heal Théoden. Now over here, I play. Nope. Hang on. Let's see. I do not want to play. I don't want to play Bilbo. But I can play Anduril and still have a resource for Fantastic Beasts. So, Anduril onto Aragorn. There's Shadowfax. Coincidentally, I then play this Westfold Horse Breeder and add Shadowfax to my hand and then shuffle my deck. So, number of allies 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, these different culverts are 9 threat each. Okay. So that's 18, 24, 27, 29, plus whichever enemy I call out, which is probably going to be a fighter because it doesn't have a when revealed. An Uruk. I can deal with when revealed. So. I said 29 plus 2, 31 threat. So it's quest 3, 4, 7, 10, 13, 17, 19, 22. 24, 26, 27, 29, 31, 35, 37. Actually, I'm probably fine either way, but let's stick with 35, should be enough. So, fighting Uruk-hai, such an event. I can discard half an Uruk-hai enemy, reveal it, and put it in the player engage view. Shuffle the encounter deck until the end of the round. Each enemy engage view adds its threat to the total threat in the staging area. So, Isengard Uruk is, of course, the lowest threat option. When revealed, either assign 3 damage on characters in control, or reveal a destroying counter card. I want to assign 1, 2, 3, and that damage readies Boromir, also revealing the Uruk readies Gimli. And second card staging is a Hillman. So, 34 threat. I pressed it for 35. So this is fine. That Hillman attacked last round. There should be a progress on the location. out of this one here and this one here. Shadow Archery 2, 1, 2. I thought about it, I probably should have had Arwen target Boromir, but I didn't think about it. let's actually just discard this. There'll be another way. Oh, yeah, of course. I've got Enduril. So Aragorn will defend against the Helmet. So he is between Enduril and the Deepened Wall, he is 4 defense. So he's fine. The Hellman faces a progress on the Deepened Wall. And then exhaust Anduril to have Aragorn counterattack between Valiant Warrior and Anduril. He's 5 attack. And so he kills the Hellman. Birkenbrand defends this. And he also defends this, which places a progress on the active location. And then attack for 2, 5, 8, 11. Kill this. Draw a card for Legolas. Merry readies Legolas so that he can also participate in this attack, killing this Hillman, drawing another card. Exhausting Arad to place progress on the opposing door, exploring it, meaning I can't declare any more attacks, but there are no more enemies for me to attack. I forgot that I had to reveal another card because the encounter deck did not make any progress. Soldier of Isengard, which I would have optionally engaged here in order to draw a card, and which I will say I readied Erkenbrand to defend it, and for some reason didn't kill it. Now let's heal up Aragorn and Pippin. And then ready the Warden and heal up Aragorn and Merry. At the end of the round, Elrond is discarded. Control N. Aragorn is back over here. Steward. A card here. Oh, we killed the thing with the Secret Vigil, which was 3 threat. Too many things to remember. Okay. So, again, I will play this Westfold Horse Breeder. And there are definitely no mounts in the top 10 cards, but I want to shuffle my deck because Steward of Gondor is no use to me. Cram, that's more use to me. On the other hand, I could play Bilbo and find the Wizard Pipe and see if I get something even more useful. Okay, let's play this Cram onto Theoden. And then I will use the staff to give Theoden another resource, and then play Bilbo search my entire deck for Wizard Pipe. No, actually, hang on, I take back that staff resource for the moment at least. We'll now play Galadriel. Top 5. I'll put Glamdring onto Gandalf. And none of the others are in use. I'll leave them in that order. Play the Wizard Pipe. Use it to switch Test of Will onto the top of my deck so that Gandalf can play it if need be. Over here, not much point in that Elf Stone anymore. Let's play a 1-9-8. And leave it at that. Yeah. Glare Worm. Dark Arch. Downs Runes. Scarred Boromir. Downs Runes again. Okay. So I should come out in my own. I discard. Hold on. And I'll play the Warden, the second Warden, instead of the Wandering Ent. So, how many allies? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So these are 8 threat each, so 16, 23. But only 23. And we can exhaust 10 of our catalogue to create a first card. So that'll be nothing in Surge. I am fine with nothing in Surge. So, request 4. Nine. 12. 15. 18. 21. 25. 27. 29. 32. 34, 36, 38, 40. Massive overkill. I reveal Reckless Hate, which does nothing and surges into a frosted door, and then the Hornbird. So that's an extra 6 threat I have quested successfully. After resolving the quest, which I've just done, the encounter did not place at least one focus on this stage as the result of questing, so the first pair reveals a card, which is a Deep in War. At the end of the quest phase, I place a resource. If there are 8 resource tokens here, add the defensive Helm's Deep to the victory display and advance to stage 5A. So that goes to the victory display. So, stage 4 I do not have to go to. Then there was a crash and a flash of flame and smoke. The waters of the deepening stream poured out hissing and foaming. They were choked no longer. A gaping hole was blasted in the wall. A host of dark shapes poured in. That does not happen. And it would have then shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck, discard cards from the encounter deck until X enemies are discarded, X is the number of players, add each enemy discarded this way to the staging area. So, 2 more enemies, which if I wasn't in control would have been a problem. Since I was, it wouldn't really. Over the wall and under the wall, the last assault came sweeping like a dark wave upon a hill of sand. Yeah, does not happen though. And after a character is destroyed, place one progress on this stage by passing any behind location. So just don't chump block and you're fine. But that does not happen. Instead, we go to stage 5A. The king rides out. As dawn breaks in the east, a blast from Helm's horn echoes in the valley, and the riders of Rohan charge out from Helm's gate with King Theoden and Aragorn at their head. When revealed, shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck, discard cards from the encounter deck until X enemies are discarded, X is the number of players, add each enemy discarded this way to the staging area. So, shuffle that in, and there's one enemy. It's added, not revealed, so it does not make an immediate attack. Okay, there we go. There are my enemies. With a cry and a great noise, they charged. Down from the gates they roared, over the causeway they swept, and they drove through the hosts of Isengard as a wind among grass. Skip the quest phase. Players cannot reduce their threat. If there are no enemies in play, the players win the game. So we just have to kill these remaining three enemies. And, of course, it's now pretty likely that this deepening wall is never going away. So, plus one defense to my heroes for the rest of the game, which is great. So, let's discard this crown to... Not discard the wizard pipe. Ready Theoden. Discard this crown to ready Treebeard, so that everyone can participate. So engage this Warrior of Dunland here and draw a card for Pippin. There's a second end draft finally. And we are a card fighter here. Okay, Aragorn will defend. He's got Shadow Cards as well. And there is Archery 2, which can go on Galadriel. So Aragorn defends this. Plus 2 attack and Toughness 2 until the end of the round. So it's now Toughness 4. Anduril will do nothing. He's attacking for 5 against 2 defense and Toughness 4. And it is now 5 attack against Aragorn's 4 defense, so he takes 1 damage. Erkenbrand will defend the other 2. He is currently 5 defense thanks to Arwen and the Deepening Wall. Do not return the enemy to the staging area after this attack. Heal up those 2 points of damage on my heroes. And now, yeah, Gandalf is 6 attack, Theoden is 3. Toughness 4, so I need 9, which is exactly what I just said. And now we 6 for each of these, so 2, 5, 8. Draw a card. Use Mary to ready Legolas. Trigger Arrow to move progress on the posting door. I could screw myself, well, not actually screw myself, but I could deliberately sort of troll myself and explore the Deepened Culvert and force myself to get more enemies, but I'm not going to do that. Attack for 9. I guess I'll heal Arwen and Barney. Another stack, draw another card. And then, yeah. Kill this, draw another card for Legolas. There are no enemies in play, and I've won the game. Yeah. The name of the game in this quest is really get things under control as early as you can. And I kind of managed to do that. Okay, even a pretty good score. I'm a bit concerned that I may have made some mistakes along the way. Well, I know I made mistakes along the way. I think that I corrected them all. I might be wrong about that. So, I might want to review this video to check for any mistakes that I missed. But it's worked out very nicely. It's interesting, actually, once you get to the point where you can kill enemies somewhat easily, this stage becomes less bad. Because actually, killing all the enemies and then revealing an extra card can be easier. Because the enemies are, although, like, masses of locations can be a problem. I had plenty of willpower, and it's always the enemies really that are going to kill you, so taking the approach of actually engaging them and killing them early on, even if it means you reveal that extra card, that tends to work out better. You get to the point where the extra card is not so much of an issue. If it's an enemy, you can kill it. And yeah. The ability to use arrows to clear out locations at sneaky moments, and ride to ruin, actually, though I only did that once. Oh no, I did it twice. Yeah. Well, and all that. Oh, I should have drawn a card with Lambing because I killed an orc. Yeah, that was very effective in the end. I was worried about my high starting threat as well, but everything worked out. So, thank you for watching. Oh, campaign resolution. Each player with a copy of Poisoned Counsels in his hand, deck, or discard pile has earned that bird and add the earned cards to the campaign pool. So, nope. I have not earned Poisoned Counsels, there is no other campaign resolution. I continue on to Grudge Isengard. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.